Turkish France. Welcome to my April wrap-up part 3. In this video, I will first of all talk about my monthly bookish statistics. And in the second part of the video, I'm going to talk about how I progressed in my yearly reading challenges, as well as the summary of the monthly readathons that I participated in April. In the month of April, I read a total number of 17 works. I read 3 historical fiction, 3 general fiction, 3 science fiction, 2 non-fiction, 2 mystery, 2 fantasy, 1 thriller, and 1 adventure book. The total number of pages in those works amounted to 3,904 pages. I read 7 works less than 100 pages, 1 work between 100 and 200 pages, 3 works between 200 and 300 pages, 3 works between 300 and 400 pages, 1 work between 400 and 500 pages, 1 work between 500 and 600 pages, and 1 work between 600 and 700 pages. My average page number per book amounted to 224.65 pages. I read one book published in 1920s, one book published in 1930s, one book published in 1940s, one book published in 1960s, two books published in 1990s, four books published in the years between 2000 and 2009, 3 books published in 2010s and 4 books published in the years 2020 and 2021. I read 13 books originally written in English, 3 books originally written in Turkish, and 1 book originally written in Spanish. I read 8 novels, 5 picture books, 2 short stories, 1 novella, and 1 play. I read 9 books targeted towards adults, 5 picture books targeted towards children, 2 young adult works, and 1 middle grade book. I read 13 works in ebook format. I listened to 3 audiobooks and read 1 paperback. I gave 1 work 5 out of 10, 2 works 6 out of 10, 4 works 7 out of 10, 7 works 8 out of 10, 1 work 9 out of 10, and 2 works 10 out of 10. My average rating for April was 7.64 out of 10, which was a quite high rating when compared to the other months. In 2022, I'm joining 2 monthly reading challenges. One of them is a series about series, which is a challenge that is hosted by Lizzie Faye Loves Books. For this reading challenge, I plan to progress in 22 series by the end of 2022. And I progressed in 3 series and started 1 series this month. I read İnce Mehmet 2, They Burn the Thistles in İnce Mehmet series by Yaşar Kemal. I read Cress and prequel short story Glitches in the Lunar Chronicles series by Marissa Mayer. I read the second book, The Angel's Game, in the Cemetery of Forgotten Books series by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. And I started the MLA Chronicles series by reading the first book, Dear Mrs. Bird by A.J. Pierce. And the second yearly reading challenge that I'm doing is Golden Girls Reading Challenge. For this challenge, we are reading a book that fits the prompt for each month. April's prompt was to read a book with a friend group. And I read Cress by Marissa Mayer. Cress and the previous heroines of the Lunar Chronicles series are all part of a friend group in this series. In the month of April, I joined 2 readathons. The first readathon that I joined took place between April 11th through April 17th. We had to read at least 1 backlist book which meant that a book published prior to the current calendar year, which was of course before 2022 this year, in order to participate this readathon. And I read four books for three challenges that were decided by the co-hosts of this readathon, who are Sarah at Sarah's Nightstand and Lindsay at Lindsay's Little Library. For the prompt of reading a backlist book that has been collecting dust, I read The Angel's Game by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. Although it was on my ebook library, if ebooks could have gained dust, this book would certainly be dusty because it has been on my ebook TBR for a very long time. And for the prompt of reading a backlist book that has this randomly generated color on the cover, which was Tala Magenta for 2022, I read The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Klune. As you can see, some of the clouds have a color that is very similar to Pale Magenta. For the prompt of reading a backlist book that has a scripted font for the title, I read Nobody Owns the Sky, the story of Brave Bessie Coleman by Reid Lindberg. As you can see, the title is scripted. And I read A Stranger in the Storm for this readathon as well, but it did not fit any of the prompts because I read the book in that week. It still counted, of course. The second readathon that I've joined was Picture This Readathon, which is co-hosted by Jack at Spread a Book Joy and Shelly at Shelly Swear Engine. For this readathon, because there were five weekends in April, I chose to read one picture book each weekend. I read five picture books for six prompts. I doubled up a book for two prompts. For the prompt of friendship, I read Bir Domates Hikayesi by Deniz Miray Özkiper. In this very cute picture book, tomatoes and watermelons were friends in the story. For the prompt of green, I read Sunshine, a book about sunlight by Josefa Sharman. And as you can see, the cover was green. For the prompt of home, I read Pina by Elif Yemenici. In this picture book, Pina was at first very afraid to leave the house because of the dangers outside the home. For the prompt of quiet, I read Nobody Owns the Sky, the story of Brave Bessie Coleman by Reid Lindberg. I chose this picture book for the quiet prompt because Bessie Coleman was a black female pilot who came from the society as regards to both race and gender, who have been quieted and never thought of becoming a pilot. And for the prompt of red, I read Bir Domates Hikayesi by Miray Özküper. Tomato is a red fruit, so it fitted the prompt. For the prompt of space, I read Picture Me in the Future by Craig Strasshofer. The cover of this picture book is closely related to space, as you can see. This was my summary of my reading in the month of April. I think I've had a really, really good reading month in April. I read wonderful books as well as very cute picture books. So please comment down below, how did your reading go in the month of April? And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. As for Turkish word of the day, since I read 17 words this month, I thought 17 should be the word of the day. 17 means 17 in Turkish, and 17 are our Turkish words of the day. Have a good day!